Hey, welcome back. Welcome back to our devotional time. We're moving over to Lamentations chapter 4 today. This whole chapter is going to have a lot to say about the degradation of Zion after they were disobedient to God and he chastened them. So let's take these in these slices. Let's take verses 1 to 3. Here's the reading. How the gold has become dim, how changed the fine gold. The stones of the sanctuary are scattered at the head of every street. The precious sons of Zion, valuable as fine gold, how they are regarded as clay pots, the work of the hands of the potter. Even the jackals present their breasts to nurse their young, but the daughter of my people is cruel, like ostriches in the wilderness. That's Lamentations 4, verses 1 to 3. And what do you have there? You have a picture of devastation. The Babylonian armies have come. God withdrew his protection. And the Babylonians came and wrecked the place, took away the people into captivity, killed others. There's been an enormous devastation. And as Jeremiah looks at it, as he walks through the streets around all the blocks and all the pieces of destruction, what does he see? He sees the sanctuaries not functional. He sees the big giant blocks torn away, the big things broken down. And he says, the people, you know, even jackals present their breasts to nurse their young, but the daughter of my people is cruel. In other words, there's kind of a sense like ostriches. This is one of these animals that can break its own eggs and destroy its own young very easily. There's so little understanding. They're so small. The brain of an animal like this is so small. They don't even hardly know what they're doing. And so this is the picture that Jeremiah gives us of his people. Their disobedience to God led them into this situation where they were basically annihilated, and now they're still oblivious. They don't understand quite why. You know, they're deaf and dumb and blind and naked. They don't know what's going on. They haven't really sorted it out yet, some of them. And so the people are in a bad way. So what lessons can we draw from this this grim picture? God is working for his people. He's trying to build up his people, but often his people are their own worst enemies. We are often our own worst enemies. Things that we could do to strengthen our Christian experience, be in attendance at prayer meeting, be in attendance in the study program, Sabbath school in our church, be in attendance in the worship service, be there when the church goes out to deliver food boxes to people in need, or be there when there's an opportunity to go door to door and invite people to some event you're having, or to ask them if we can pray for them or give them Bible studies. There's so many things we can do to bring hope and encouragement to people, but a lot of times we don't participate in those things, and we ourselves are discouraged. People go to church because it's got a wonderful music, or the preacher, we really like the preacher. We should go to the worship to be encouraged and strengthened in following the Lord and to strengthen others. We should go there not because we're consumers, just soaking in the good stuff. Hey, this church has got better good stuff than that church. We should be in attendance at worship because it's God's way of building us up and giving us opportunities to serve others. But here's a picture of a people who have really, in a dramatic sense, lost their way. Now they've been going through God's chastening, and they've been come out in a very bad way. We are often our own worst enemies. We're missing spiritual opportunities that God is giving us. Oh, why? We damage our prospects, but God gives us new opportunities. Is he giving you new opportunities today where you live? I hope he is, and I hope you're taking him up on them. Let's pray together. Dear Father in heaven, we want to be right. We can see here people that are devastated, smashed up, and they still are kind of blind and don't know quite what's going on, most of them. Many of us are in a case, Lord, where we need your help. We need to be helped to go forward and to give ourselves, to spend ourselves serving others and to be doing the work of the kingdom instead of just thinking, you know, oh, it's a sad thing. We can't go and sit down and just open our mouth and just receive all the things we want to receive there. That's not about consuming. It's about living for Jesus. So help us to live for Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for hearing our prayers. In Jesus' name, amen. Hey, may God be with you today in all that you do and in all of your service for the kingdom.